Hey guys, it's Lori Ballen, and I was asked to make a video on how to send out your home buyer's guide and home seller's guide to your customers. And I'm going to talk about a few things as we go through these because this is kind of developing now as we go. So if you have created a home buyer's guide or home seller's guide, they're going to be right here in your designs. If you have not yet, you're going to click the little blue plus sign at the bottom right, and you're going to go to print, click next. And then we're going to go down here. You've got listings and a listing presentation, booklet style, and you've got a buyer presentation booklet style. Okay. Now, the idea, the concept is that these would be working in correlation with your guides that we're going to be using in our app and in the opportunities phases. So let me open that in a new tab here as well so you can see what I'm talking about. So down on the left, if we go down to consumer and we go to guide builder, what you're going to see is you have a buyer's guide and you have a seller's guide. You're going to want to edit these so that they match up with whatever was in your buyer presentation. So there's some defaults here. And what's going to happen is during the opportunity phases, like somebody goes into escrow or they execute a contract or they're in the offer phases, when you start marking those in your phases or opportunity stages, you're going to have the ability to have these appear so that the customer or client, so the client can see what happens next and what is it during this process, right? So we all want to customize these so that they really fit our own market. And one of the things that we're working on now is also adding a timeline with this because I have a custom buyer's guide that has a timeline and a custom seller's timeline as well. So I like to let them know, okay, from the day we start our search, here's what you can expect. This is about how long we'll spend in this stage, your pre-approval stage. And you can drag and drop these around too so that they're in different order. So maybe you start with the pre-approval and you'll say, okay, this is going to last about 7 days. And then we're going to do our home search. So we're going to start by setting you up on an MLS search and sending you properties. You're going to narrow it down. We're going to pick a couple days. So touring homes, that usually takes, a couple weekends. So we'll give this one 14 days and then you're making an offer and that's probably gonna, could take up to a week with counter offers and whatnot. And then once it's accepted, this is what happens next. So your buyer guide is over here. These are like your booklet. So I'm gonna go ahead and click use. You have two different covers. You have the red and white, and then you have the black and white. And here, what you're gonna do is you have multiple pages in this design. And you're able to go through page by page and customize each section. This is your instructions page. So it tells you what to do, and then you're going to remove that page before you actually save this or go to print with it. Okay. Now, let's just say you're done with this, and the person that requested this video said, "Hey, Lori, I actually want to send the buyer's guide over by email or by text through a link or attachment to my buyer that I start working with." That makes perfect sense to me. I can totally see why you'd want to do that. Okay, so you've got options. Of course, you can print all this, but let's just say you want to send this to them digitally, and then you let them know that you also have this little guide that's going to pop up on their app or on their website during the transaction, Okay, so let's just say you finish this, and you're going to save this as Lori Ballen Team Buyer's Guide. Okay, from here you've got the option to download it. So before you do anything else, I would suggest actually, first let's save it. So we'll go up to the left-hand side, File, Save. Now here you can check your print quality, you can manage the bleed before it prints, anything else that you want to do there. And then we're going to go to Download. Now you can download this as I'm going to download it and get the PDF. And then you're going to need to choose how many pages are actually in this design. I forgot to mention, that we need to actually go through each design, each page, and click it so that it becomes part of our design. And again, you really want to go in and edit these. See, here's a great spot for that timeline I was talking about. So you go through and do all of those. Then we save, and then we download. And you see here now it says download range from 1 to 8. So if you don't go through each page and click it, it's not part of your document. So once you've done all of that, you've got it the way you want to, and you want to download this as a PDF, go to all designs and standard web quality or high resolution print quality, depending on what you're doing with it, and then click download and save it to your computer. Okay, now for sharing, I'm going to give you a couple ideas, although this is very likely to change in the very near future on how these are going to go out. And we've kind of got to do a little bit of a workaround right now because there isn't, that I can find, there isn't an easy way yet to make a link to this. I have played with this and I've tried the sharing links and we're getting error messages. So I'm going to have to show you a couple different ideas here, okay? So to send this out, one thing that you could do is you can go into your contact that you would want to send this to. So let me just pull myself up here as an example. Filters off. Okay. So now what I could do is I could just simply click email. It'll open Gmail as long as you have activated. And then subject line would be, here is your buyer's guide, for example. And then I would just make a note here of some kind. Hey, Sally, I wanted you to have this buyer's guide. Then I would go into attach files and I would find the buyer's guide that we just downloaded, which is in, where is it? I don't know where it downloaded to. Maybe it didn't download. Let me see. Download, get PDF, start download. Lori Ballen Team Buyer's Guide. Preparing. Okay, there it is. Desktop, Lori Ballen Buyer Guide. Okay, so it's in a PDF document. So to check it, we can just go down here and open it to see what it looks like. Perfect. Okay, this is great. This is what we want. Okay, now in order to share this link, we're going to have to put it somewhere where it's shareable, where it's hosted. Now, the concept is that here we're supposed to be able to go to share and click a link, and then that link will be shareable, but it's not pulling up right, at least not today on my computer. So the workaround would be go to the contact, click their email, and then click the little paperclip to attach, and then attach your buyer's guide. I didn't download a cover, that's why it's white, but then they would get it this way. That's one option. Another option would be to create a link somehow to that PDF. So for example, I've got other websites like my WordPress blogs. I can upload that to a WordPress website and grab the link. Okay, so it would look something like this. I go over to my real estate website. I'm just giving you several workaround options. I go to new and I go to media. And then I would select file, upload my buyer's guide. And again, as soon as they have that link working, we'll be able to use it inside command. Or if they give us the ability to upload a file and grab the link. Okay, so then what'll happen here is if I click edit, you're going to see a URL link right here. I can now use that link to share with anybody and they'll be able to get my PDF guide. Okay, so any WordPress website you have, that's an option. Another option would be if you have something like Dropbox, you could go to Dropbox, upload the file. And then once it has uploaded, you can right click. Actually, we can share and then we can create a link to it. So I'm going to click create a link and then anyone with this link can now view the file. And then it looks like this. Okay, so they could browse through all the pages like this. That's another fine way. There, if you Google get a PDF link, there's lots of tools that will actually do this. So the concept is what we really want is a link of some sort because we cannot yet attach through the smart plans, okay? So the next thing that I would do is I would create a smart plan so that I don't have to go find all those links. It's one and done. So I'm going to go ahead and create a little smart plan. So on the left-hand side, we go to smart plans. Smart plans are basically your email campaigns, text campaigns, that kind of thing. I know it's confusing with the word campaigns because they have campaigns being quick posts and Facebook ads and whatnot, but we're all used to calling them email campaigns. So a little confusing there, but we're going to go down to smart plans and we're going to click create. And I would call this buyer guide. I'm going to put test sample so I know it's not a real one that I'm using and then apply. And then choose the trigger event. Okay. Well, right now the only trigger event they allow us to choose is manual ad. At some point, those will trigger based on a tag or a stage or a phase or an action of some sort. So what I would do is I would say, okay, when I manually add them to this plan, send them this email. So the subject would be your home buyer's guide or something of that nature. And then you would say, hi. And then use a merge field by clicking here and their first name will be filled in now. Then comma, I am looking forward all of us at Lori Ballen team are looking forward to working with you. I've prepared this home buyer's guide to inform you of the process. I'll follow up in a couple of days or however you want to close that, okay? Okay, and then you're going to sign it. So if you look at merge fields, those are all contact merge fields. So you would just sign it, Lori Ballen team. Okay, now, here is where you're going to put a link in. So highlight the keywords that you want the link to be attached to. So right here I say, I've prepared this home buyer's guide. Now click the link and we're going to add in the link URL. So if you're using Dropbox, you're going to take that link up there. If you added this to your own website, you're going to take that link right there, wherever you have the link to that PDF. Oh gosh, where's my spot? Too many tabs open. Okay, then we paste that right there and we click add link. Now, if you also wanted them to get a text message at the same time, click new action. Actually, we don't need to click it. We'll just do click send SMS. And then you could actually just copy the same message down there like that. I am going to just import the real merge field because I want to make sure that populates the same way. Okay. And then make sure you highlight that link. Oh, in a text message, you have to include the link at the end because you can't attach it in the same way. Now, if your link is too long for a text message, what I do is I go over to bit.ly, and that is a URL shortener. And I have a free account. I go to create, paste in that long link up here. See that long link? Way too long for a text message. Paste that in right here. Ah, create, paste, okay. And then it will give you, you know, let me just make sure I did it right. Create, paste, there we go. It'll give you this short URL right here. Okay, so I'm gonna call this my home buyer's guide. I'm gonna put samples so I know it's not the real one. Okay, and then click copy, and then go over to your text messages. And you're just gonna paste that link right there at the end. Or I prepared this home buyer's guide. You could put it here if you want. And then sign it Lori Ballen. Now, in order for your text messages to work, you have to have Twilio set up. Twilio is not free. It does have a cost, but it's a very inexpensive cost, like less than a penny a text or something. So if you don't know how to do that, let me know in the comments and I'll get you a video. I have a video on how to set up Twilio, okay? So once you've done that, they would get this email and they would get this text message as soon as they're added to this campaign. If you don't want the email and you only want to send by text, you can get rid of that first email. You can also play with your letters. You can play with bold, italics, underline, lists, changing the font color and style, left to right, and links. You can do all of that right now in your email. And then once you've got this done, you save it. And then whenever you want to add somebody, you can either add right here from the Smart Plan by clicking this button here, and you'll be able to add them. So let me just save it so I can show you. Okay, you can add people by tag. So you can add bulk people here. So if you're tagging based on stages or phases or whatnot, then you can drop them in here. Or maybe you've got a tag just that just says current buyer or something like that. You can put them in. And then your other option would be to go to the contact record themselves once they get into that phase. And then go up here to Smart Plans, click the plus sign, click Add to Smart Plan, Add to Smart Plan, or right here, Add to Smart Plan. And then your Smart Plan that you installed was called Home Buyer's Guide Sample. You can see all your steps. And then you would just, that's not the right one, but that's okay. There it is. So then you would click Select, and as soon as you selected an Adam, they would instantly get that email and text message as soon as they go out. So there's a few ideas for you. Be prepared for this to develop because we're gonna have easier ways to do this as we move on. But the fact that we can just set this up one and done in a Smart Plan makes this super easy. At this point, it's something you can start using at least today. I'm Lori Ballen with 365 Days of KW Command right here in Las Vegas, Nevada.